Fabian, his work against the cage was tremendous. His control was excellent. He's a phenomenal wrestler against the cage. He's just got to work on his output.
Our next fight is about to start as we have seasoned veteran Joe Smith fighting out of Lauzon MMA, making his fourth walk to the cage. He is 2-1. He's a stud wrestler. His pressure is relentless, and he's looking to do much the same tonight.
Yeah, Joe Smith, this guy is just, he's improving with every fight. He only has one loss. His only loss is to the flyweight champ, Cape Cod Cowboy. But yeah, every time we see him, this kid gets better and better. Great camp like Lauzon's MMA. I mean,
it's a big name to have on your belt in the local scene. He's getting patted down right now. Vaseline'd up. He's very composed in there. He never lets the light deter him whatsoever. He's a man on a mission, and he wants to take you down and grind for three rounds, make you suffer. Pressure, pressure, pressure is the game plan of Joe Smith, and I don't think it's going to be any different tonight.
And his opponent here, John Semenuk, he's coming from Junico. Now, this is his debut, but as you and I know, John Semenuk, the nephew of UFC veteran George Rivera, our former coach. This kid, he's been training for a very long time. His jiu-jitsu is top-notch. I'm very excited to see his debut.
This is not the first time he's had a debut scheduled. He's been looking forward to this for years. He's always, always wanted to make this walk. He's a composed kid with a very thick jiu-jitsu background. He's got very solid hands. He's looking to brawl. This is a fight I'm very much excited for. It's a great matchup because the relentless wrestler in Joe Smith is facing a seasoned jiu-jitsu practitioner in John Semenuk. Like you said, nephew of George Rivera, he's been doing this for a long time. I remember the first day of the gym I rolled with him, he tossed me around like a rag doll, and that's never changed. Every time I roll with him, he's a beast on the mat. This is a matchup I'm not predicting the future here, but I think that Smith's gonna land a takedown and we're gonna see some interesting exchanges on the ground. I'm excited for this matchup.
Yeah, Smith can definitely not look past John. This is John's first fight, but you can't, just because it's his first fight, they wouldn't give him a guy like Joe Smith if they weren't sure about him.
I'm getting the jitters for this. If you're a fight fan, stay tuned in this one. There's gonna be a lot of technical goings in this fight. I'm excited to see it. He's calm and composed as he makes that walk into his cage, and he receives a warm welcome here as John Semenuk makes his first walk to the cage. Harry Jones about to get this one official. The beautiful Cassie signaling round one.
135-pound amateur max upset for 3 rounds, 3 minutes apiece. Introducing first, in the left corner, he has an amateur record of 2-1. Representing Lauzon, MMA, giving up for Joe Smith. His opponent, in the blue corner, making his amateur debut, representing Team Unicorn,
cage doors closed. The cage door is locked. We got this. Kevin McDonald, our referee. Smith, Semenuk, the touch of the gloves, and we're going here at the 135-pound.
He punches.
Smith lands a combo, flush to the face of Semenuk. Right off the gate, Semenuk eats it. He gets an underhook. He's diving for that double leg. Smith looking to grab a hold of the head. As Semenuk just clasps his hands together. He scores that takedown up against the cage. Smith with his back pinned against it, but don't think that he's not gonna stop working. He's got that head bit down with a couple of butterfly hooks in. He's using it to reverse.
Semenuk stops it.
Pulls his hips out, lands on top again. landed some punches to the body. It looked like he ate a couple of real good punches there in that exchange. You think he's taking this time to clear the cobwebs a little? I don't know how rocked he got, but he definitely ate some shots.
Yeah, Joe Smith came out hard there with those big punches. John Semenuk ran right in for those takedowns. Right now, working on that front headlock.
Oh,
and there's the guillotine.
He's very flexible. He's got an arm in guillotine.
That's
he's leaning
tight.
Forward. That's how you
that
finish it.
Tight.
This might be deep.
John Semenuk, the bull shark. They call him the bull shark for a reason.
That looks deep. It's under the chin. The arm is in. He's arching backwards, but he's got the arm in. Don't you got to lean forward to really get that torque and under the neck with the arm in guillotine?
Yeah, Joe Smith, he's doing it. He did a good job there. You saw he tripoded up to relieve the pressure.
He's out.
And then he popped his head out.
He's out. Pops his
very
head out. Fights the wrist.
There.
And this is the matchup I thought we were going to see. Joe Smith playing his game in the guard of Semenuk, trying to posture up and work it, but Semenuk is excellent at controlling the wrist. He's got a very active guard. I'm excited to see how this one plays out now. It looks like Smith is trying to pin the left. Never mind. Smith's got a bite on that. He's got a bite on an overhook to Smith's right arm, and he's throwing some punches from the bottom. Semenuk very composed on the bottom here.
Yeah, think about John, that,
oh, what
nice
a sweep.
There.
Beautifully timed that step over from Smith, and he turns it into a reversal and finds himself on top against the cage. Smith looking for an armbar. He might have that attempt pretty deep.
Watch that arm.
That armbar attempt is deep, but Semenuk's no stranger to this ground game, and he's punching from the top. He's got to stack him a little bit more and try to eke that elbow out of that armbar attempt.
Yeah, he's doing a good job stacking him there. What I was going to say about John is that rolling with him, he has super long arms for a guy who weighs in at 135. He's always tough to roll with. I mean, that can be a blessing or a curse, as we see right now. Joe Smith's looking for that armbar.
Looks like Semenuk is circling the right way, but that elbow still hasn't made it past the crotch of Joe Smith. So he's still, that arm's still in jeopardy as this round comes to a close.
There's
big
a slam by John.
Punches from the top from Semenuk. He's landing him good. This is exactly what I was waiting for. A technical matchup on the ground. They're takedowns from both fighters. A quick striking exchange to start it off. Smith getting the much better of that. But it was surgical groundwork from both fighters. The armbar attempt, the reversal from Semenuk. This is what you want to see in a grapplers matchup.
Yeah, both guys, very interesting ground back and forth. Both guys in their corners, they look super composed. John did a good job ending that round pretty dominantly. He was in the arm bar, he was in danger, but he did a good job. He stacked Joe up, he dropped some hammer fists on him, and then he picked him up and slammed him.
That first 2.5 minutes was extremely close, with Smith getting the better of the striking exchange, of course. Semenuk spending a lot of time on top, doing some more damage with his punches. But that armbar attempt, what do you score more for there? The armbar attempt or the ground and pound from the top? Because both men were in danger scoring points in that position. It's a tough round for the judges to score.
Yeah, it can get pretty subjective there when you're on the ground. It depends on who you talk to. Some people say the strikes are more important, but then some people say that those submission attempts are huge.
All right, the touch of the gloves to signify the start of the second round. Smith coming back where he left off as he lands a nice combination, dives under for a single, but John Semenuk, he sprawls out of it. He's looking to dive under with an underhook there, but Smith, relentless wrestling as we predicted.
Yeah, big high crotch there by Joe Smith. Switched off to the double, and now he's getting stuffed into the cage.
Look at the power of Semenuk's ground game. As he takes a seasoned wrestler like Joe Smith and reverses him with relative ease on brute strength at this 135-pound division. He finds himself in a little armbar position again. I don't know if that arm looks like it's in jeopardy again. Smith doing a great job rolling under and landing that arm.
Yeah, every time Smith is going for that armbar, John's got to get out of that, pass his guard here.
Staying composed, stacking well, much like we saw at the end of the first. Like we said, he's got an extensive jiu-jitsu background as he's landing thunderous hammer fists.
Now this isn't
and
all.
Smith actually looking to block them with his leg.
Yeah, that was in the past. Yeah, this isn't a horrible spot for John because even though Smith is threatening with that armbar, he's stuck against the cage, so he can't go belly down or anything.
Very true, but it still looks like he's got wrist control of that arm, which is giving Semenuk a little bit of trouble finishing this pass. as he's sneaking out, inching inch by inch to get around this attempt and land in a dominant position.
Yeah, Joe's got to get that leg back around and go for that triangle. But again, like I said, he's stuck against the cage.
Oh, he's got a crucifix position. Smooth transition to that. But Smith against the cage.
Ooh, this is tight.
What?
He scrambles out.
What can you? What more can you ask for in a grappling matchup right here? You're seeing two. Look at the dexterity of the legs as he takes the back from what most people. He's like Gumby.
Wow.
He takes the back.
Yeah, John's got super long limbs.
Oh, what relentless pressure from Joe Smith as he reverses out. But Semenuk diving for the armbar, rolling underneath. Oh, this is tremendous.
Yeah, B's got to go belly down.
Looks
here
like a
really
deep.
Crank that arm.
Looks deep, but that cage might be stopping him from finishing it. He's recognizing that, trying to roll off the cage to finish it better. Trying to angle himself. He might have that. I can't see exactly what he's grabbing at.
I think he's trying to put a triangle on. No, he's still going.
Nope, he's still got it. But Joe doing a good job keeping his wrists clasped.
Oh yeah, he's looking for that triangle.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Oh, this is
that
the triangle I've talked about.
That
I've tapped this triangle
tight.
Many times myself. That looks
so
like it's fine. Very deep. He's controlling the head. He's pulling it down. Smith doing a good job stacking, his best.
I've seen Joe Smith get caught in triangles before. He's gotten out of them before.
Oh, and he reverses and he's on and up on top. And he's got the tap.
Semenuk
wins.
It. Wow.
Semenuk wins. Oh, beautiful. I think he might have gone out. Semenuk wins by triangle in the second round. A fantastic grappling matchup between the debuting John Semenuk and the experienced Joe Smith. A fantastic fight. I love the matchup. It did not disappoint. Smith with the aggression, with the wrestling. Semenuk with the technical jiu-jitsu. Finds the armbar, doesn't finish it, transitions beautifully to the triangle, and he ultimately gets the tap and wins by second round submission. Excellent performance from the debuting John Semenuk. Your uncle George Rivera is very proud, I'm telling you that right now.
Yeah, that was some really, really technical jiu-jitsu. John did such a good job of switching off from that armbar right to the triangle. Beautiful.
Joe Smith, though, no knock on him. He's as tough as they come. That's a tough opponent. Tremendous fight from both guys.
Yeah, no knock on Joe. Joe will be back for sure. Just a tough matchup there. But sky's the limit for John, that's for sure.
I knew I was excited for this matchup. My first finish of 2017. Comes that way of triangle in the legs of John Semenuk. Tremendous debut from John Semenuk and a tremendous fight from Joe Smith. Awesome, awesome fight from both guys.
Yeah, another win for Team Junico already.
Junico 2.